We're here at Stellantis' Connor Avenue Assembly Plant in Detroit, Michigan, former home of the Dodge Viper, and we are getting our first look at the new body-on-frame Jeep Wagoneer and Grand Wagoneer. These three-row products are two of the most important to come out of Jeep in years. Here's what we think.
To recap, here's the current and rather confusing state of Jeep. A few weeks back, the company introduced the redesigned Grand Cherokee and the three-row Grand Cherokee L. Now it's adding the Wagoneer and Grand Wagoneer. The redesigned Grand Cherokee and the three all-new entries give the off-road brand a substantially bigger footprint in the hugely important utility space. Put another way, where before the brand only challenged two-row mid-size crossovers, it's now taking the fight to three-row midsizers, mainstream body-on-frame three-row SUVs, and luxury-focused three-row SUVs.
We're here at the back of the Wagoneer. Now, this is the same size as the Grand Wagoneer, but you gotta kinda keep in mind Stellantis' approach here. This is more of a Tahoe competitor, where the Grand Wagoneer is more of an Escalade competitor. They're not different size vehicles, they're the same vehicles, one is just much ritzier. But this is still really nice. Look at this gorgeous design. I love the way the back is squared off like this. I love the raised way that the letters are. It gives them a real cool 3D effect. In general, Jeep has stayed very true to the Wagoneer concepts, and that's a good thing. This is a very attractive vehicle. You get these familiar Jeep headlights, but you get this great cutout for the license plate. I don't know why I like this. It's so unusual, and it looks fantastic. I love the thin pillars right here, and the way there's very little chamfering around here. It's a great looking design. Going around to the side, you can get an idea of just how big this thing is. This is a three-row SUV. It is a body-on-frame SUV. It is a full-sizer. The design on the side is somewhat slab-sided. It's not a bad thing. It's, again, true to the original Wagoneer. Here at the front of the car, and we are where the engine lives. This is not just your grandpappy's 5.7-liter Hemi V8. This has Stellantis' e-torque system. Total output is 392 horsepower and 402 pound-feet of torque. Is available with a two-speed transfer case, although two-wheel drive is standard. But that engine has enough to tow nearly 10,000 pounds. Stellantis hasn't offered specifics on the towing figures yet, but that figure is huge for a body-on-frame three-row SUV. Like the exterior, the interior stays very true to the Grand Wagoneer concept. You have these big glass displays. This is a 10-inch display running Uconnect 5 in the middle, and a 10-inch display running an all-digital instrument cluster here. You get this beautiful two-spoke steering wheel. I really like this design. I'm glad that two-spoke steering wheels are catching on. It harkens back to older designs. You get this Wagoneer badge right here. It reminds me a lot of what Land Rover does with the airbag caps on its vehicles. Otherwise, it's a minimalist cabin. You get a bank of buttons here for the climate controls and this really chunky dial right here for controlling it all. This is a very clean, stylish, attractive cabin. And while this is a pre-production tester that we're in, the material quality looks very, very high. And remember, this is the Wagoneer. This is not the Grand Wagoneer. The Grand Wagoneer is gonna be even better.
The interior of the Wagoneer can seat up to 8 passengers, although as per usual, the 7-row configuration with second row captain's chairs is the plushest setup for all involved. While Jeep isn't sharing exact measurements, it's promising best-in-class passenger volume, total volume, second and third row legroom, and cargo volume.
All right, now we are here with the Grand Wagoneer. This is not a larger Wagoneer, it's just a nicer one. And when we say nice, we mean nice. It is full of all these little exterior design details that make it feel richer and more premium. You have this beautiful silver all over the car. There's chrome strips. The lettering moves down from the hood to the grille, and you get this really lovely copper accenting. Copper is underused in accenting vehicles. I want to see it more. It looks awesome. Now, if we come around to the side, you can see larger standard wheels. And while this blue body makes it hard to spot, there's a black contrasting roof. That's gonna look amazing in white or red or gold. Give me a gold Wagoneer with a black roof, please. That'd be awesome. Again, you get this silver and chrome accenting around the windows, all to make it look a little bit richer. If you come around to the back, again, it is the same basic design, but again, more bright work, more copper accenting. It looks good, it looks premium, it looks rich, and it needs to because this vehicle starts at $87,000. It starts at $87,000.
The Grand Wagoneer's interior is similar to the Wagoneer's, but again, it feels far richer and far screenier. Jeep is promising up to 75 inches of screen real estate spread across 7 separate displays. It's taking glass-intensive design to a borderline unreasonable extreme, although we can't wait to play with all the Uconnect 5-powered gear. The Grand Wagoneer also makes substantial improvements to material quality, which didn't really seem lacking in the first place. Knurled patterns abound, and there's rich Palermo leather nearly everywhere you look. There are even quilted upholstery options, which seems like a must considering the Grand Wagoneer's target market.
The Wagoneer and the Grand Wagoneer will be available in 3 trims when they arrive on sale later this summer. Series 1, Series 2, and Series 3. At least there aren't any crazy names to remember. But there's more. A long wheelbase model will be arriving later in the year, offering even more space and more luxury. For Motor One, I'm Brandon Turkus. Be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, and wherever else you get your social media.